Hey everyone, it's Rachel back again with another reaction video, and today I'm going to be reacting to a new song from Patient 67. It features Rory Rodriguez of Dayseeker, and it is called Anathesis, and I'm excited about it. I've been wanting to do a reaction for Patient 67 since I did Gustavo Bling, I believe, and I've been wanting to do more. They do a good job with keeping content coming out, keeping new music coming out. Things have just been so busy, so this just aligned perfectly for me to finally be able to follow through with. I've been telling them I'd do another video, so this is the perfect timing. This has just dropped. Patient 67 is awesome. They put out a fantastic EP last year, Home Truths, and had one of my favorite, I say this a lot, I had a lot of favorite choruses last year, but Where To From Here is a song from Patient 67 that is, it's just so good all around. Everything about it, fantastic song, love that, it's my favorite Patient 67 song. So yeah, today I'm gonna check out this new track. That is pretty much where we are at. I'm gonna stop talking and we are gonna get straight into it. Patient 67, featuring Rory from Dayseeker, Anathesis. Let's discuss. Very cool. I dug this. I've definitely dug the visuals as well. The space stuff also, you're kind of getting like a performance piece with the visuals of the members of the band. And then also, you're still getting the lyrics, which I dig that combination very much. the opening drumming type sounds that were going on in the very beginning before the song really opens up. I like those a lot. They kind of, for some reason, that reminds me of like the movie, like bum 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 bum. Y'all know what I'm talking about? I think it's Paramount or something. But I like that. It gives it like I don't even know how to explain it. I'm not gonna go into it too much, but that's what it reminds me of personally. Like the type of drumming that was in the very, very beginning of this, the build up on the beginning of the song, kind of before it really opens, and then once it does open and you get Tom's vocals and everything, it's an energetic opening, which I love to see. I like that. I liked a lot of the pronunciation with on the uncleans and the clean vocals as well. Other than Rory's part, I feel like Rory, his vocals, it wasn't the same because he does his own style, and like I feel like his vocals just flow a certain type of way. But other than that, there were just like the way that some of the syllables were broken up with the words. I really dug the way that a lot of the pronunciation was done on this. It sounded cool to me. The chorus, I definitely dug. Love the clean vocals on this. I think that Where To From Here still has like my favorite chorus, but I really dug the chorus on this. It's catchy. The way that door is said, it sounded great to me. The pause before I'm stuck here was something I also really dug. The guitar spin and stuff. I just thought the visual, that's another part where like the visuals were very cool to have. But I like having that while also still getting the lyrics, because I've talked before about how much I like to know the lyrics that I'm hearing. I like to read through lyrics, stuff like that. So I dug the visuals, which I already talked about. Tom's vocals, I think, still sounding great. I thought it on the EP last year, and then we got some additional singles, and I think that his uncleans are sounding on point. I really dug the Rory feature on this track. I'm always wondering, and I always say this too, I feel like with features, like how it will fit and stuff, and I feel like the song really opened up the way that, because Rory, if he's doing, you know, because in Dayseeker, he does some uncleans, but when he's got a part like that, like, it's a really, like, smooth style, so the song kind of opened up, and you even see, like, in the visuals, kind of, like, chilling to let the slower part of the song, and then the energy picks back up at the end. So I dug Rory's part. I think that if there was something, there were two things that I think I would do with this song, and one would be to like have a little bit of that like punchier sounding snare on the drumming. I think would have sounded really good on this song. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. I'm trying to think of a good example of it, but it would be like, actually, like on the new Reflections album, that's where I can think of like that suit. I don't know why I keep doing this. Like, you're gonna know what I'm talking about based off of this. But there's like a super, I guess the best way to describe it would be like punchy sounding snare. And I love the way it sounds. And I think it would have been really cool on this one. I still dug the drumming though on this track, don't get me wrong. Really dug the drumming on this. But I think that would have like hit differently for me, as well as getting a bit more bass. Like, I feel like in a lot of the songs we've been getting recently, the bass is like more present, and I'm now like noticing more when it is, and I'm like, you know what, in this part right here, it would sound really good if the bass, like on the new Era track that we just got, how you have one particular part where there's like a ton of bass, but throughout the entire thing, you can just hear more from the bass, and I think a lot of times that hasn't been the case with music, like in general, like the bass has just been kind of overlooked in a lot of bands that I've been into at least, and now it's the bass time to shine. It's coming out this year. 2021's the year of the bass. So I would have added, like, you know, put that up a little bit more, because I couldn't really notice it too much. But the guitar sounded really cool throughout the whole track. I just would have liked to see a little bit more bass. And that's too, that's what I do. I like to pick apart songs. And I really dug this, though. So great stuff from Patient 67. They're awesome people as well. Definitely check out their social media and such. I will put the links in the description that you may need. They also have a Discord server that I'm a mod in, if you're interested in joining that. I will link it in the description. We love Discord here. Let me know what you thought of this song in the comments. And Patient 67, great job. Thank you for being patient with me. I know I've said a couple times that I'm trying to get to a video for you guys again. So here I am. I'm glad I finally got it done for you guys. And this was a great one to do it for as well. I love this track. So let me know what you thought in the comments. And if you have an unrelated song that you'd like to see added to either of the lists that I work off of when I'm doing request-based videos, both links will be in the description, as well as the invite link for the Discord server. We love the Discord server. It's a lot of fun. Sorry, I keep clinking my ring. I'm like, I'm gonna put this coffee cup down. We love the Discord server. I will put the link in the description. It's been growing like crazy. Thank you to everybody who's joined recently. Appreciate you very much. If you would like to join, you like online communities, chat rooms, such, and you are willing to be kind to other people, the link will be in the description. And lastly, if you are enjoying the style of music, bands, and content that I post here on my YouTube channel. I post more music related content on my Instagram. My handle there is Rachel Reacts, same as my YouTube channel, but I will put it up here on the screen for you, as well as put my Linktree thing with all of my social media links and such in the description of this video. As always, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it.